अस्सलाम वालेकुम एवरीवन। सो दिस इज़ अ थर्ड लेक्चर फॉर चैप्टर फिफ्थ, दैट इज़ फॉर्म्स ऑफ मार्केट। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स वी हैव सीन द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ मार्केट, वी हैव सीन परफेक्ट कॉम्पिटिशन और परफेक्ट कॉम्पिटिटिव मार्केट, एंड नाउ वील स्टडी वॉट इज इम्परफेक्ट कॉम्पिटिशन और इम्परफेक्ट कॉम्पिटिटिव मार्केट। Meaning of imperfect competition. On the basis of competition, there are two types of market: perfect competition market and imperfect competition market. We have studied perfect competition already. Now we'll see what is imperfect competition. Imperfect competition is a type of market showing some but not all the features of a competitive market. That is, it will have some features of perfect competition and some other features or some new features that we have not studied, which are different from perfect competition. And unlike perfect competition, this type of market do prevail or do exist in the real world. And it can be further divided into three types, that is monopoly, oligopoly and monopolistic competition. The first type of imperfect market or imperfect competitive market is monopoly. The term monopoly is derived from the Greek word mono, which means single, and poly, which means seller. So monopoly means single seller. Monopoly is a market in which there is only one seller who controls the entire market supply for a product which has no close substitute. We'll see the definition given by Chamberlain. So according to him, monopoly refers to a single firm which has control over the supply of a product which has no close substitute. In simple words, monopoly means there is only single seller available in the market which is selling his or her product to the buyers, and the product is mostly homogeneous and there is no close substitute available for that particular product. So that single seller is in a position to influence the market. Monopoly does not exist in large number. There are very few examples of monopoly. As far as India is concerned, we have the example of monopoly in the form of railways. The Indian railways have monopoly. Government have monopoly in railways. That is, there is no substitute available for railways. There is no competition available for railways. There's only one type of trains that works in India, and that's Indian Railway run by the government. So that's an example of monopoly. Now we'll see the features of monopoly. The first one is single seller. As the definition itself suggests, monopoly means single seller. So it is one of the features of monopoly that there is only single seller in the market. In monopoly, there is no competition, as there is only one single producer or seller of the product. But the number of buyers is large. Single seller and large number of buyers. No close substitute. This is also part of definition. There are no close substitutes for the product of the monopolist. Therefore, the buyers have no choice. They have to either buy the product from the monopolist or go without it. The cross elasticity of demand for his product is either zero or negative. That is, there is no close substitutes for goods and services. And since there is no substitute, that means there is no competition. If there is competition in the market, then it will not be called as monopoly. Another striking feature of Monopoly is the barriers to entry. Entry of the rivals is restricted due to legal, natural, technological barriers, which do not allow the competitors to enter the market. The single seller controls the market. He does not allow any other competitor to enter the market. He can put any legal restrictions, or there could be natural restrictions available. All this creates barriers for entry in the market. And because there is no entry, there is no exit. So there is no concept of free entry or exit in Monopoly. Complete control over the market supply. The monopolist has complete control or hold over the market. He is the single producer or seller of the product. He does not have any competition. There is no other seller available for selling the product. So buyers do not have any control. The buyer will have to buy the product or service from that particular seller only. So that monopolist is in control of the market. He controls the market, he determines the price, he determines supply, and so on. A very important feature of Monopoly is that he is the price maker. A monopolist can fix the price of his own product as he controls the whole market supply. He is the price maker. He is responsible for fixing the price, and buyer will have to follow that particular price only because there is no other option available for the buyer. So he is the price maker and not the price taker. Price discrimination. Monopolist being a price maker, he can charge different prices to different consumers for the same product on the basis of time, place, and so on. Thus, price discrimination is an important feature of monopoly market. For example, students and senior citizens are provided railway tickets at concessional rates. So there is only one product, one service available, that is of railways, but different prices being charged from different buyers or different consumers. So it's all in the hand of the monopolist, and there is price discrimination in monopoly. There is no single price followed. Different price are charged according to different time, according to different place, or any other criteria. No distinction between firm and industry. For this, first we'll understand what is firm and what is industry. Firm means a single company or a single factory, whereas industry means group of firms or group of companies. Now, for example, Reliance. Reliance is a single company. It deals in various products, and one of the products that it deals in is petroleum product. Reliance Petroleum. There's also other companies like HP Hindustan Petroleum, BP Bharat Petroleum that deals in petroleum products. When all of these companies are studied together, Hindustan Petroleum, Reliance, then we say that there is one industry form, industry of petroleum products. And in that we have different firms like Reliance, HP, and so on. So firm is single company, and group of firms is called as industry. Now, in monopoly, monopolist is the sole seller and producer of the product. A monopoly firm itself is an industry. There is no difference between firm and industry, as there is only one firm, one seller. That is, single firm constitutes the whole industry. There is no competition. There is no other firm. So industry cannot be firm. Firm is equal to industry. We have studied the features of monopoly. Now we'll see types of monopoly. The first type is private monopoly. When an individual or private body controls a monopoly firm, it is known as private monopoly. For example, Reliance Industry or Tata Group or Google or Facebook, all these companies are run by an individual or group of individuals by a private body, and therefore it's called as private monopoly. Public monopoly. When the production is solely owned, controlled, and operated by the government, it is known as public monopoly. It is usually welfare oriented and not profit oriented. It has more of social purpose. For example, Indian Railways. Indian Railways are run by the government and their main motive is service and not profit. The next type is legal monopoly. This monopoly emerges on account of legal provisions like patents, trademark, copyrights, and so on. The law forbids the potential competitors to imitate the design or form of the product registered under given brand names. For example, Amul Products. Amul company can create a monopoly by getting its name, brand name, copyrighted, or getting a trademark or patent rights. By imposing this legal restrictions, monopoly can be created. Natural monopoly. The monopoly created on the basis of natural conditions like climate, rainfall, specific location is known as natural monopoly. Like producers of tea from Assam will enjoy natural monopoly because of the natural conditions, climatic conditions available there. Or we can say wheat from Punjab. All these products are available naturally, and because of their natural availability, the producer gets the advantage of natural monopoly. Simple monopoly. In simple monopoly, seller or firm charges a uniform price for its product to all the buyers. It is also called as single price monopoly. The monopolist abides by the law of one price. That is, everyone pays the same market price for all the units purchased. Simple monopoly firm charges a uniform price or single price to all the customers. He operates in a single market. This is any simple monopoly where there is no price discrimination. Discriminating monopoly. In discriminating monopoly, firm charges different prices to different buyers for the same product. For example, doctor charges different fees from different patients. Or we can take the example of a student concession. If you go to a particular amusement park, then there's different price or different concession available for students. Or we can take the example of any football match ticket or a movie ticket, where different prices are charged for different categories of customer. There will be different price for adults, there will be different price of ticket for children, for old age family members, and so on. Different price is charged from different group of customers. That's called as discriminating monopoly. Or differentiation can be on the basis of place. That is, the house rent is different in rural areas as compared to urban areas. Or it could be on the basis of time. For example, bus tickets or bus fare is different in morning times or at night. So all this is used as basis of discrimination and different prices are charged. The last type of monopoly is voluntary monopoly. To avoid cutthroat competition in the market, some monopolists voluntarily come together and form a group of monopolists. This facilitates them to maximize the profit. We can take the example of Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries, that is OPEC. It is an organization whereby different petroleum producing or exporting countries come together and they fix the price for petroleum products. So there is voluntary monopoly created by this organization. This helps them to increase their profit. That is, this helps them to earn more profit. With this, we have completed types of monopoly. So we have seen the feature, meaning of monopoly, types and features of monopoly. And that's all for this lecture. Thank you.